Snakes, rats, and silk moths all have pheromones. But do humans have pheromones? Yes, pheromones do exist, 100%. They were actually discovered in the late 1900s. But do humans secrete them? And if they do, can we detect them? Very important stuff, you know. There are a lot of studies going on between humans and pheromones, but not all pheromones are used to attract a mate. Such as there's snakes out there that use pheromones to help find their prey. In humans, scientists are still trying to figure out if we have pheromones or not. There are some studies where they're trying to figure out what causes babies to be able to identify their mother's breast from across the room. But the thing is, just because a baby can identify its mother's breast from across the room doesn't necessarily mean it's a pheromone. We can be attracted to certain smells, such as a widely known 1994 t-shirt experiment where they had people exercise and then they would smell the clothing of other people and rank the clothing that they smell from least attractive smell to the most attractive smell. Come to find out, the higher the immune system a male had, the higher that they ranked. But there is a problem with these experiments, and that is that they're just way too small or they just can't be replicated. But then there's the boar, which has saliva with a pheromone called androsthenol that gets the female pigs to assume the mating position. Turns out those molecules, that pheromone, can be found in human sweat. How's that for dating advice? Absolutely amazing! But can we detect them? And do they work? Snakes, lizards, and rodents all have an extra organ in their nose to help them identify these pheromones. It's called the VNO. But absolutely sad news that humans probably don't have them, and if they do, it's just left over from the evolution, like many things on your body. But even if we had pheromones, it'd probably be more subtle than direct. If we're attracted to someone because of the smell, it's more about the contacts than the actual molecule makeup. If it was pheromones, then that would be completely different. It wouldn't be about the context at all, because it would be all about the molecule makeup. Does that make sense? And I don't know about you, but if someone goes around clubbing baby seals, I'm not gonna be attracted to them no matter how well they smell. On another note, I guess it seems that all those ads on Pornhub or on the Google is just all marketing fluff and snake oil about people selling pheromones. Now, you might be in the comments section saying, there's still hope to find them, or you can't prove they don't exist, or you might just be calling me a joke in the comments section. Science doesn't exactly go around disproving things. It just proves that things exist. Does that make sense? So if someone makes the claim, hey, this is true, then they have to back it up with a claim. And that's what I'm doing. I sourced everything, all of the scientific links down in the description, so you can nerd out all you want, okay? Nerd out all you want. It's all you, okay? Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and thanks for watching. For humans, scientists are trying to figure out what causes humans. But then there's the boar, which has saliva. Oh my gosh. Well, that was...